So Apple recently released their liquid glass update and designers are going crazy about it. Everyone's trying to build it on code in different ways. And so today we're going to build it in the most easiest possible way inside of Unicorn Studio. And so we're going to try and copy this effect that's hovering into text. And so the final output is going to look like this. As you can see, this is all real time. This is Tree.js inside of Unicorn Studio. As you can see, there's a cursor right there and we have that glass effect hovering over to magnify. And so this is gonna be an easy tutorial. It's just about 10 layers, which is not a lot inside of Unicorn. And so let's try to do it from scratch. So first things first, of course, you have to start a new project. We'll just get in here, change this into 1920 by 1080, of course. And then we wanna change our background into white. Then, of course, this is white. We want to introduce a little bit of a gradient there. We can search for vignette, put that there. And we're going to change the radius and then the fall off. We can mess around the skew. There we go. And then the fall off better. Decrease this more to about 190. And then from there on, we can change the mix into just turn opacity down so that there's a little bit of a, you know, like it's not too much. There we go. And the next thing we're going to do is, of course, we're going to create some text. And so we're going to put in here like liquid glass. All right, and then we're gonna put this in the middle, center that so it's not hard. And then we can change the font size here to something like that. It's a little bit tricky to work on their on Unicorn Studio's text, so you gotta be careful around that. Let's change this to black instead of inter-regular. Maybe we could go with 600 or maybe just 500. And then change the letter spacing to around that. And the font size to be lower. There we go. Okay, so we got that there. Change it a little bit. There we go. And then now we're gonna okay, now that I have the text, the next move here is to actually create the cursor of the text. And so the way that we could do that is simply creating a rectangle. And so maybe we could put it into 10px of maybe 50px or 100. There we go. It looks like a cursor already. Maybe we can make it about 80. There we go. 80px. Change the color to this one. And we have that. And then we can change the border radius to 100%. As you can see, it works. Change the height maybe to 90. There we go. It's perfect. It aligns perfectly as a cursor. Okay. So the next thing that I would do is make sure that that is centered. And there we go. Now, the question is, if we do the interaction, like how does it follow the cursor? And it's a very simple animation here. It's just one click here. You just put the mouse tracking to 100% and now it's following your cursor. And you could easily just select with your cursor. Now, let's turn that off first because it's going to be bugging us as we do. Now, the next thing that we want to do is creating that liquid glass effect in itself. And so how do we do that? Well, in Unicorn, it's really not much of a big deal. It's like a very easy effect inside of Unicorn. You could do lens distort. Lots of ways you could go about this. You could just use the normal lens distort and it already works, right? But that is not the effect we're going for. Plus, there is no way to work around with the right shape that we want to do, which is this one. So what do we do with that? So first, let's delete this. And we're going to use an effect called 2D SDF, which means it is like a 2D effect that has all that refraction and dispersion. We can change the scale. And still, it's still a rounded thing. It's still a circle. So how can we put a custom shape of how we want in here? So that is easy. The first thing that we have to do is just export the shape that we want from Figma. And so let's go to figma.com. And inside of this project, we just have this. Let's create the shape, put the border like that. There we go, border radius, and that's the shape that we want to achieve. Simple as that. And then we're just going to put it as SVG, export, boom, and now it's inside of your downloads. Okay, now how do we change the shape of this? And so instead of using circle, you're going to click on custom, change the SVG into this one, which I've already uploaded for the sake of the tutorial. So wait for it. There we go. Now it's actually there. We can change the scale just a tad there so that it's not too much. We can change the refraction on what we want here. Like we could go negative, which is not the look, or we can go positive to make it big. There we go. We can change the dispersion just a tad because it's not too much on the Apple example. And so now it's there. Perfect. It's already working as how we want it. The next thing that we would do is just the animations of it. And so what I want to do here is track the mouse to 100%. Same thing with the shape, track the mouse tracking to 100%. But the difference is the momentum of this one to about 79. Let's see how that looks. And so as you can see, if you put the momentum zero on the cursor and the momentum of the shape to about 79, it feels like it's doing the effect of what we have on the Apple example. So we could even scale the 2D shape just a tad more. And there we go. That is the effect. And so we can export this and preview this on how it looks. So we can put it in production. Put it 120 and then publish that, and then we can go preview. Okay, so we are being taken to the preview. Okay, so we are here. As you can see, it's actually really, really fast, and I'm super proud of what we have here. as you can see, it's now doing its thing. We have that effect right there. We can actually select text and the cursor is working as intended. So that's it pretty much. I hope you like this tutorial. Pretty much this is just the most basic way you could do liquid glass, but you could, with the principles that we have and the tools that we have in Unicorn Studio, we could easily do more stylistic things inside of this platform. With that said, design faster and move faster. We have so much tools all around that we don't even have to code this. We have AI, we got everything. And so I hope you enjoyed that very quick tutorial on Unicorn Studio. I know it's very basic, it's just dispersion effect, but the thing is, with what I just showed you, we have so much options that we could design more with more stylistic things inside of Unicorn. And so stay tuned for more tutorials. We're going to be making tons of these and I'm super excited to do that. Let me know if you like this video, comment if you have any questions, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time.